back, folks. Gonna be doing some Microsoft Flight Sim in Antarctic. We're in a caravan, just in a caravan. Taking off on the ice. I think it said 11 foot of snow with the runway. This is pretty cool. Phoenix Airfield. Ocean over here that's froze. I'll take a gander at these mountains over here. Thought they'd be a cool little place to venture off to. Hope everybody's having a great day. Be sure to hit that like button. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and be sure to click on the notification bell and select it to all so you can get the latest notifications. All right, yeah, we're cruising around the Antarctic. It's probably pretty cold. It's really cold. I'm just being a little sarcastic. Let's see if we can get our trim where we need it here. That's a pretty good medium there. That'll work. All right. Got a few heels right here. Got some clouds over on top of that mountain. Take a gander at our aircraft here real quick. It's a caravan. It's Emerald Harbor Air. Okay. That's a cargo bays on the bottom. Ooh, it's a little different. Flying it totally backwards. Get turned back around here before I crash it. There's another runway, but it's ice runway. Ice runway. A little mark in the snow. That's about all you get. That is all you get. There's some landmarks. Oh, there's a tanker, some wind farms, or a wind farm. Over speeding, not really worried about that. Just trying to get there a little quicker. Yeah. Keep it back a little bit just so it'll turn off. Looks like it's iced in. We'll need an icebreaker to get that one out. Unless it has a hole to break certain thicknesses of ice, which I'm sure it probably does. They reinforce the holes on the ships that fly around the Antarctic. Other places it's froze, or it freezes. Throttles back up a little. Get over here to this mountain, maybe. If we get there. Not much to see across the snow. So. Okay. Yeah. I'm nice. This is the middle of the day for this area. So, that sun, it's almost probably high as it's going to go here. That's all right. But that's why it stays froze, so the sun doesn't stay up long enough to thaw anything out. It's a little bit, bumpy. It's a little bit. Zoom out a little bit. Just get my head out of the picture. Make it over there in the mountain. Too fast, but it's a cool little trip out over here. some frozen ocean. What they called the airport we took off from said it was, usually it says like asphalt, 11,000 feet or 9,000 feet asphalt. This one said 11 foot of snow. The runway description. That was pretty cool though. Let's see if I get up here in this cloud here for a little bit of extra scenery. Might be a little bit high for this aircraft. We'll be in the cloud here in a minute. Try not to stall it out. Bit of a speed back. All right, now we're getting ready to go in the cloud. This view, you're not going to see anything. Nothing. Instrument panel there. Not gonna see much this view either. Okay. Going through the clouds. Try it. Controls touchy with this aircraft, that's for sure. Going through thick clouds. See if we can get above it here a little bit. Not losing too much airspeed. Top of the mountain. Peeking up through the clouds, it's pretty cool. It's a great shot there. 9,500 feet. Cruising around the Antarctic. This in the Caribbean. Yeah, it's smoother up here for sure. 10,000. Very smooth. There's the mountain. You can see the radar on both sides, both screens on the left and right on the instrument panel. And it'll show you the mountains even though you can't see it out the whole mountain through the windshield for the clouds, but it sees through the clouds, which is pretty cool. And the middle one's a terrain map. Shows you different elevations. The darker it is, higher it is, lighter it is, lower it is. Get a little closer to the mountain. Get above the cloud here if we can. We got enough speed. There's the top of the mountain. We finally made it. See what kind of views we get from up here. Yep. Alright, doing pretty good on speed. Right above the clouds, 11,600 feet. It's pretty smooth, sort of, somewhat. And, yeah, we get on top of it. This is a pretty tall mountain, actually. It's about 11,000 feet, looks like. Great views from up here, great views. See if I can look around a little bit without me crashing. That's a pretty good view. Somebody behind us. This is a little bit difficult flying backwards. Yeah. A pretty good shot. And yeah, it looks like this might be around 12,000. 12,500 maybe. It's way up here. All right. Let's see if we can go up and take a peek over the top of it. I want to thank everybody for coming by and watching. And as always, you know, be sure to drop a like and be sure to leave me some comments. I love reading the comments. I always like to see what people's thoughts are about different videos, and if you like it or you'd like to see something else done a little different, or have a place to request for me to fly, like on another video or during a stream or even a short, as far as that goes, that'd be pretty cool. I'm all about requests with Flight Sim. It's got all kinds of opportunities, that's for sure, because it's worldwide, anywhere in the world. All right, that's a pretty cool view. View from inside. I said 12,500, this mountain peak might be around 13,500, more like it. This is pretty close. Yeah, I don't think they say 13,700. Jeez. All right. Way up there. Thanks everybody for coming by and watching. Until next time, we'll see you. Keep on rocking.